church as well reminds me a bit of the things that my first performance actually that I ever did. You know, being baptized a Catholic, you get roped into all these kind of bizarre staging of events, you know. But I was at one of the Three Kings, which is my first big showbiz moment. When I was 7 years old, and my mum made me quite an incredible outfit. I looked a little bit more like Liberace, I think, than one of the Three Kings. But before that, my first ever thing on stage was, do you know this song, The 12 Days of Christmas, my dream of me, a partridge and a pear tree, this song, yeah? Okay, I was the pear tree, and I had the partridge on my head, and this is all I can think about right now, I think. You know, how did it begin? Why did I end up touring most of my life and doing this? But I think it's that moment of being wrapped in brown cardboard with a partridge on my head. I think after that, nothing really scares you. And I have a lot to thank for that moment in time. But this has nothing to do with it. It's song. I wrote originally all on my own when I was going through a bit of a kind of I don't know even what was going on. Young male anger at the world and kind of shaking my fist at everything and stomping my boots around town. And so I was all about revolution back then and this idea of like you could change everything with a little bit of aggression. And of course that's completely the opposite of how things get sorted. And that's how wars begin and stuff. So I was kind of out to fight the world. And luckily I kind of grew out of that. And I ended up writing the song again with a great singer-songwriter called Buffy St. Marie. And she kind of came in and helped me channel a little bit of pacifism in the lyrics. So we took out the word revolution, and we thought that this was about full circles, so there's no point in a revolution. And I guess it's quite brave of her to mention that, but a revolution is a full cycle. But if you want to change things, then resolution is a lot more powerful device and aesthetic. So no more revolution, more of a resolution. And that's how I came to rewrite Hard Times. So.
Out since 2000. Hard times if you own it. See ya.